The red-cockaded woodpecker inhabits the sand hills of North Carolina and the coastal plain region. It is listed as an endangered species by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. Through the cooperative work of U.S. Fish and Wildlife, the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission, and many public and private partners that participate in the Safe Harbor program, it has a good chance of a comeback. My name is Jeff Marcus, and I'm a wildlife diversity biologist with the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission. Red-cockaded woodpeckers, or the RCW as it's commonly referred to, are really fascinating critters which are entirely dependent upon a mature and intact longleaf pine ecosystem similar to the forest that you see behind me here. The availability of large tracts of open longleaf pine forests is shrinking. The loss of this habitat can be attributed to fire suppression as well as conversion of the forest to other land uses such as agriculture, loblolly pine plantations, and urban development. The Wildlife Commission and other agencies are working to protect RCWs on public lands through land management activities, including the use of prescribed burning and installing artificial cavity nesting boxes that expand the nesting habitat. These fires, which are low-level controlled burns, help to mimic the natural fire regime that historically maintained these stands, and they also help to reduce the risk of catastrophic fires. The Wildlife Diversity Program of the Wildlife Resources Commission strives to protect all of the biodiversity of North Carolina, the species, particularly the non-game animals of the state. We work to do it through doing research and surveys to understand more about these animals, but also by hands-on management to improve habitat for them and land conservation activities that help to protect the land upon which these animals depend. Safe Harbor is an important program because it benefits not just the species but also the landowners, that it helps address any concerns they may have about restrictions under the Endangered Species Act, so it gives them the peace of mind that they can manage their land in a beneficial way without having future restrictions being placed on them from endangered species, and in the meantime all these species are benefiting from it. So it provides multiple benefits, not just for the animals, but also for the landowners. Let's go take a look at the nest tree and see if we maybe get a chance to get a look at one of these Bachman sparrows along the way, which are also calling in this stand. You can see the bird flying right through there.
We've got several red-cockadeds flying around. They've got a nest in this tree with eggs in it at this point. And so they're sharing incubation duties right now, and hopefully we'll be hatching within a couple days. So we're standing next to the nest tree here, so we don't want to stay in this spot for too long and keep the birds from incubating. But another point about Safe Harbor is the other benefits that come along with working with these landowners and building trusting relationships, such as some of our Safe Harbor landowners have gone on further and have placed conservation easements on their property, and some have sold their property to conservation buyers that now means that their land is protected in perpetuity, and so the woodpeckers that occur on their property are protected permanently as well. So that's been a great benefit in addition to just building those trusting relationships with landowners and creating a positive atmosphere around an endangered species.
Red-cockaded woodpecker is not the only species that benefit from the Safe Harbor program. The North Carolina Wildlife Action Plan identifies many priority species that depend on longleaf pine forests. These include Bachman sparrow, bobwhite quail, brown-headed nuthatch, Carolina gopher frog, pine snake, eastern coachwhip, eastern diamondback rattlesnake, eastern tiger salamander, fox squirrel, and southern hognose snake, among many others that benefit from the management of the forest to maintain that open understory that RCWs need.
Well, being on a Safe Harbor agreement and managing the property under their guidelines is just good land management, especially in the longleaf pine ecosystem. And after burning and thinning the loblollies out and improving the longleaf stands, I have seen a lot more turkey. I've seen turkey on property I've never seen turkey on before. Quail, bobwhite quail, a lot of the different snakes, pine snakes, corn snakes, hognose snakes, canebrake rattlesnakes, and a lot of other bird species, songbirds.
My opinion is that the woodpecker isn't in trouble because it's a stupid, dumb bird and ready to go extinct. It's in trouble because the ignorance of man and the greed of man has taken away the habitat. So what used to be roughly 90 million acres of habitat has been reduced to 3 million acres So every time we can put an acre back into mature longleaf forest production, then that will, I think, help the red-cockaded woodpecker as well as everything else that goes along with that and the longleaf pine to survive and thrive and be there for us to look at 100 and 500 years from today.